السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. It's very hard to talk about akhira after dinner. إذا امتلأت البطون نامت العيون. So when the stomach after is full, the brain typically goes to sleep. It's a very interesting word that when the brain, when the stomach is full, typically because the blood, the brain or the body tries to shift the blood from, you know, other organs into their stomach because it's digesting the food, it's trying to do the job it's supposed to do. So we won't be long, inshallah, we'll keep it, inshallah, short and to the point. Inna alhamdulillah, ahmaduhu wa nasta'inuhu wa nasta'firuhu wa nasta'dih. Wa na'udhu billahi min shururi anfusina wa min sayyati a'malina. Innahu man yahdihi Allahu fala mudilla lah. ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وحبيبه اللهم صل وسلم على سيد الأولين والآخرين عبدك ورسولك محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه ومن استنى بسنته واتبع هداه إلى يوم الدين. Brothers, thank you very much all for coming along and for staying up to this hour of a Friday night. But I wish to tell you, be assured that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, whatever you do, for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah rewards you whatever you've done 10 times. Sometimes the steps you have taken forward for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you do not know what action and what specific deed you have done that will actually save you on one day. And if you and I, or if we all cannot sleep at night or cannot do great deeds for this religion, at least when we sleep at night, we sleep with the intention that we will not commit sins and that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bring us, will gather us, resurrect us amongst the prophets, the salihin, the martyrs, and amongst the best quality of his nations. I was given a very delicate topic to discuss with you in a very short amount of time, so there won't be time to go through everything in detail. But what I wanted to touch base about and tell you about the Akhirah is that the Akhirah simply is an extension of what we are living here. So this life is literally a bridge, a stage to a life yet to come. But if you read carefully into the Quran, if you open your heart to the Quran, you will live every single part of that life. You will see it. You will see it right in front of you. Until that, when that day comes, then you have lived, literally, you've experienced everything. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made a surah in the Quran that is called Surah Al-Qiyamah. So he says, فَأَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ
لا أقسم بيوم القيامة ولا أقسم بالنفس اللوامة أيحسب الإنسان أن لن نجمع عظامه بلى قادرين على أن نسوي بنانه.
The beginning of that day. We won't go through the exact narrations, interpretation of each part of it, but we will just briefly touch base on every ayah, simply. The Arabic language is an interesting language. So when the Quran says La Uqsimu, which translates not yet, I swear with the day of resurrection, that la in the beginning in the Arabic grammar is an extra la. So it actually has no space in what we call i'rab or in the language itself. So what then it means, When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala swears with something, then you have to listen. Such a great thing coming. Then he says, لا أقسم بيوم القيامة ولا أقسم بالنفس اللوامة. The Quran defines in other parts of it three types of nafs. He tells you that he is the creator, subhanahu wa ta'ala, has made three types of it. One of these nafs is the one in this surah, النفس اللوامة. The nafs, that type of soul or that type of self that always provokes an individual as to not why you've done the evil, no, why did not you do the good? It's not why didn't you go out tonight, no, it's why didn't you stay up praying tonight? So it makes the lawm, a lawm in Arabic, it blames you for not doing the evil. No, it actually blames you for why didn't you improve your status? Why didn't you do more? Why didn't you do more? Why didn't you pray more? Why didn't you give more charity instead of $10, $50, for example? Then the second type of nafs, which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala spoke about in another part of the Quran, in Surah Yusuf, he says, إِنَّ النَّفْسَ لَأَمَّارَةٌ بِالسُّوءِ إِلَّا مَا رَحِمَ رَبِّي. It's a second type of nafs, the ammara, and that nafs always provokes an individual to do evil. The third type of nafs, and that is the highest quality of all, that is النَّفْسُ الْمُطْمَئِنَّةِ. And that self-assured, satisfied self, or nafs, the Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes it right at the end of Surah Al-Fajr. Then the Quran or the Surah talks about them hereafter. أَيَحْسَبُ الْإِنسَانُ أَلَّا نَجْمَعَ يَظَامَ. Then you think, well, the Quran is saying, isn't a human being, a man, thinking that we cannot bring his bones together? Then the Quran answers the question and says, Bala, yes, we surely we can bring his fingertips together. So what does that all mean? Why is the Quran specifically talking about the fingertips or the fingertips? So in order to know this, we'll have to go a little bit scientific. So you go and actually find out that the human body contains substantial number of bones. Over 206 little joints. They're very connected together somehow. It's not just about the joints. When the Quran talks about the thing, why the fingerprints? Why didn't the Quran say, no, we're able to bring that skull bones together with the spine, which is a very complex part of the human body? No, the Quran says, no, we're able to just bring the fingertips together. Now, nowadays, we discover that these fingertips, that they have the skin that has multiple layers, and these layers, they make your fingerprint. And we know today that it is extremely unlikely to find two fingerprints that match each other. Now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells you, despite how many billions of you in this universe, we are able to match which fingertips from the ground belongs to which body. We will bring that all together in the day of resurrection. يوم يقوم الناس لرب العالمين. The time, as soon as they hear the sayha, they get up from their graves. They are running forward. They don't know why. In complete darkness. This is typically what the Quran says. If you read it carefully, the moment after death, two types of lives. That hayat is called hayat al-barzakh. And it can be as good as heaven, and it can be as terrible as hell, but it can be as simple as just a sleep. And suddenly you wake up. People wake up, they get up from their graves. They listen to the da'i. Someone is calling them out. Come. Come to the day. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brings you forward to Him, then we come to Him. And I want you to listen carefully to this.
وَجَاءَ رَبُّكَ وَالْمَلَكُ صَفًّا صَفًّا وَجِيءَ يَوْمَئِذٍ بِجَهَنَّمَ يقول يا ليتني قدمت لحياتي فيومئذ لا يعذب عذابه أحد ولا يوثق وثاقه أحد يا أيتها النفس المطمئنة ارجعي إلى ربك راضية مرضية فادخلي في عبادي وادخلي جنتي.
وجاء ربك والملك صفا صفا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that He, in His glory, comes. He comes on the Day of Judgment. He, ليس كمثله شيء. Whatever you think what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is like, it is not what you're thinking. He's way different. Something that you've never expected, that you've never thought about, does not cross your mind. He comes the way that suits His glory, subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَجَاءَ رَبُّكَ. And the angels in rows behind each other. But us, we are standing like this in one row, not behind each other. You look forward to the Malik. You're looking at Him. He is calling out to you. No one is standing behind each other. It's not one row. It's horizontal row. We all watching the day of on the Day of Judgment. The angels are surrounding that very long, long horizontal row. Now I want you to think carefully, picture it, and imagine it on the day. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says He comes. The angels are different rows. And then Jahannam, somehow He allows it to come along. Jahannam has a smell. Jahannam has a sound and a strong voice that people hear from a distance. That Jahannam, Al-Quran describes it and says that it has a sound and it has a noise that people recognize. It's calling out to those who will enter it without an exit. سَمِعُوا لَهَا تَغَيُّضًا وَزَفِيرًا. Then, وَجِيءَ يَوْمَئِذٍ بِجَهَنَّمْ. What happens to us? What happens to you on the day? يَوْمَئِذٍ يَتَذَكَّرُ الْإِنسَانُ وَأَنَّ لَهُ الذِّكْرَ. You and I standing up there trying to remember. Yes, this is the day that we've been told about. This is the day that the Quran came and told us exactly what is it going to be like. Is it going to benefit you or me, what we remember then? It won't. يَوْمَئِذٍ يَتَذَكَّرُ الْإِنسَانُ. You will remember. In a day or in a night like this, yet you've given up the family time and you've sat here, despite the difficulty you've had, and you've listened. You heard what is being said for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That one, you will remember the times that you've given up for the sake of the dunya and you've given up for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then he says, Ya laytani qaddamtu lihayati. And again, you go to the Arabic language. Ya laytani is something that will never happen. I'm hopeful for something that will never happen again. Which is different in Arabic if I say la'alla. So in Arabic, it's a different word altogether. When you say ya laytani, it's completely different to you saying la'alla, it will perhaps happen. Al Quran describes how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also comes in another verse and says, وَنُزِّلَ وَيَوْمَ تَشَقَّقُ السَّمَاءُ بِالْغَمَامِ وَنُزِّلَ الْمَلَائِكَةُ تَنْزِيلًا. الْمُلْكُ يَوْمَئِذٍ الْحَقُّ لِلرَّحْمَنِ وَكَانَ يَوْمًا عَلَى الْكَافِرِينَ عَسِيرًا. وَيَوْمَ يَعَضُّ الظَّالِمُ عَلَى يَدَيْهِ يَقُولُ يَا لَيْتَنِي اتَّخَذْتُ مَعَ الرَّسُولِ سَبِيلًا. يَا لَيْتَنِي اتَّخَذْتُ مَعَ الرَّسُولِ سَبِيلًا. يَا وَيْلَتَى لَيْتَنِي لم أتخذ فلانا خليلا. I wish that I did not take this person or that person as a friend. Against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's pathway. وجيء يومئذ بجهنم يومئذ يتذكر الإنسان وأنى له الذكرى يقول يا ليتني قدمت لحياتي فيومئذ on that day لا يعذب عذابه أحد ولا يوثق وثاقه أحد. Then Allah talks to the self, to the self-assured nafs. ارجعي إلى ربك. Come to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. ارجعي. Come back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that you used to worship. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one that you worship all your life. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in another verse, لِلَّذِينَ أَحْسَنُوا الْحُسْنَى وَزِيَادَةً. One day, on that day, after people, those who go to heavens and those who go to the hell, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala comes to them and says and asks them a question. He says to them, is there anything that you would like from me? Is there anything that you would like me to give you? And listen to the politeness of the believers in the Day of Judgment. They reply and say, أَلَمْ تُبَيِّضْ وُجُوهَنَا. You've changed our faces to be white in the day. You've saved us from the hellfire. You've given us everything that we've imagined. You've given us everything that we've asked for and everything that we didn't ask for. And then at the time, that barrier between you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala disappears. And then they get given the pleasure of looking at Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's face. So when you and I meet our parents that we didn't get to spend time with in the Day of Judgment, then imagine how happy you would be. Now think about it, how happy you would be looking at Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's face, imagining that right in front of you. The highest level, the highest prize that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can give the believers, which the Prophet also spoke about, that some people from the Jannah, in the Jannah, they see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the morning and at night. Now what a great prize, what a great thing to have, what a great thing to deserve. The nights they've given up for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The money they have donated for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The time, the effort, everything they have spent, everything they have done, it comes to the end where the test has completely finished and they come to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and Allah says to them, what more can I give you? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, كل من عليها فان ويبقى وجه ربك ذو الجلال والإكرام. That everyone on this earth, on the surface of earth, will die. When the angels heard it, the first thing they said was, Halaka banu Adam. The children of Adam, they will completely die. But when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Kullu shay'in halikun illa wajhah, that everything besides his face will disappear from the entire existence, then even the angels knew at the time they will die as much as the children of Adam will die. Only the face of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, wajhullahi yabqa. It is only that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will stay, will remain. The entire existence will disappear. The entire universe will go back to the state where it actually originated. And as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, يَوْمَ نَطْوِ السَّمَاءَ كَطَيِّ السِّجِلِّ لِلْكُتُبِ. The heavens and earth, it's the day we bend it like this, as the day initially was created. It's a day that again was described in the Surah Al-Qiyamah. فَإِذَا بَرِقَ الْبَصَرِ وَخَسَفَ الْقَمَرِ. The moon will eclipse. The moon will go to complete darkness. The sun will disappear. It is the day, brothers, that I've come today to remind myself and to remind you that it is coming. And it is the day that we should try our best to do something for it. You know, if it is not for that day, it is for the sake of watching and looking at Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And remember, this Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also says two things. In Surah Al-Mutaffifin, Allah says, أَلَا يَظُنُّ أُولَٰئِكَ أَنَّهُمْ مَبْعُوثُونَ لِيَوْمٍ عَظِيمٍ. Don't you think, or don't those who commit sins think that they are, or they will be resurrected? They are coming one day in front of me. Yes, they will. But maybe they're forgotten. And when he says, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, يَوْمٌ عَظِيمٌ, a great day, a terrible day, it means its effect to you will be a billion times terrible. When Allah gives it the description, عظيم, what description would you and I would give it? يَوْمَ يَقُومُ النَّاسُ لِرَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. And the last thing he says in those who will not be able to see him, كَلَّا إِنَّهُمْ عَنْ رَبِّهِمْ يَوْمَئِذٍ لَمَحْجُوبُونَ. Certain people will be told to go away. Certain people will be told that they're not allowed to see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Certain people will not be given the pleasure, the utmost prize on the day of judgment, of just looking at his face. كَلَّا إِنَّهُمْ عَنْ رَبِّهِمْ يَوْمَئِذٍ لَمَحْجُوبُونَ. Believe it or not, there's a group of people that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will have the barrier between him and them. They will not get the honor of seeing him. Now what is what? Life is not worth anything at all. The entire existence is what is worth nothing besides looking at Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's face. Today is a reminder for you and I that we don't want to be amongst those who will, there will be a barrier between you and them. So from today, if you can't let go of your sins, if you can't let go of your mistakes that are now a barrier between you and the mosque, that are between a barrier between you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, at least sleep the night with the intention that you will not make a sin. Sleep the night with the intention that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will resurrect you with those who He is blessed with. When the Prophet was about to die, when he put his head over Sayyidah Aisha's lap, and he was asking his wives, what day is it? What day is it? And they knew he was asking, when is the day he's spending with Aisha? When he had his head over between her chest and her lap, Aisha was just, she's not hearing anything. All she's hearing, she remembered that the Prophet gets given a choice whether to stay or to go. And all she could hear the Prophet ﷺ saying, مَعَ الَّذِينَ أَنْعَمْتَ عَلَيْهِ مِنَ النَّبِيِّينَ وَالصِّدِّيقِينَ وَالشُّهَدَاءِ وَالصَّالِحِينَ. I want to be amongst those who you are completely blessed with. Those who are النَّبِيِّينَ, the Prophets, the Siddiqeen, the Martyrs, the Salihin. This is the group I want to be with. She knew he was leaving. She knew at that moment that he was dying. And this is what you and I tonight will be praying for. It's if you give just one night for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and asking him truly to be amongst those, inshallah he will give you and I that honor. And it's the same, the verse that ends when he says, فَدْخُلِي فِي عِبَادِي. Go to that soul, مُطْمَئِنَّة, go amongst عِبَادِي. Believe it or not, there's a group that will have the barrier that we talked about. There's another group that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created since the time in the beginning of history. And that group he chose. That group he gave them the ability, you know, out of his mercy, out of his fadl. And yet, he is taking this group into his paradise. A group that he selects, a group that he gives his book to, a group that he gives Islam to, a group that he gives Iman to. He's given that to you. He's guided you to come here tonight. You did not come here without his permission. I didn't come to give that speech without his permission. Of course not. So he allows you and I to be here together. The fadl. Yet, you know, he rewards you for it. So think about it. He is giving you a reward for something that he is the one that brought you over to it. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is merciful, is compassionate. So I'm hopeful that tonight we will make some changes. We'll remember that the day-to-day life in this country is too busy. It takes you away from everything. It takes you away from the mosque, the children and the work, takes you away from everything. And I will finish very shortly, but take it as an opportunity to remember that there is an Akhirah. Surah Al-Qiyamah came for those who did not believe in the Akhirah. And the reason they didn't believe is because they don't want to have a commitment. They want to live a free life. They want to live a life without any commitments, without any restrictions. Why should I restrict myself from doing anything? It's a free thing. It's a free country. It's a free. Everything is free. But in Islam, we have discipline. You discipline yourself, and it is such a pleasure to feel in your heart that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes and puts and makes you feel it. It's such a great pleasure in your heart when you resist temptation, when you resist doing the wrong thing. I'm hopeful that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give us the ability to resist every temptation to go against Him, or to go astray. I'm hopeful that tonight we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to gather us, to direct us amongst those who are with the prophets, with the martyrs, and with the salihin of His nation. I'll ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tonight to help us all and bring us to His mercy and put us in it. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وإسرافنا في أمرنا وثبت أقدامنا اللهم ما كان من توفيق فمنك وحدك فلك الحمد ولك الشكر وما كان من خطأ أو نسيان فمني ومن الشيطان والله ورسوله منه براء أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم. Thank you for listening and I hope inshallah you see you again.